Hey, welcome back everyone. My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. Today we're going to be taking a closer look at the brand new multiplayer map Kremlin. This is going to be coming with Call of Duty Advanced Warfare Supremacy DLC on June 2nd for Xbox 360 and Xbox One. This is actually one of my favorite maps in the DLC. I actually prefer this map over Skyrise, which is pretty interesting. If you missed the Skyrise gameplay, I'll link it down below in the description, by the way. So like I was saying before, this is a very large map. Kremlin takes place on the outskirts of the presidential palace in Moscow, Russia. It's a very beautifully designed map. The colors pop really great. You got lots of high and low grounds, and like I was saying earlier, once again, it is large. It's great for pretty much any playstyle you have. Sniper's paradise indeed. It's going to be good for assault rifles, great for heavy weapons and SMGs, because there are a lot of close quarters areas, especially when you're playing certain modes like hardpoint and domination. Now, we were able to play two different times on this map, kill confirmed and game of hardpoint. Hardpoint is awesome because you have two different turrets on both sides of the map, so both spawns get a turret up in the top of these towers. You can watch down onto the hardpoint location, so if you have a teammate that's down there, kind of like behind cover, holding the hardpoint location, you can have a teammate up on the turret protecting that objective as well, which will basically make it so you can try to gain as many points as humanly possible before being taken off of that hardpoint location. You can also use your turret to spray and fire upon the other enemy that will be across from you on that turret, so it's always going to be an engaging fight there. The middle of the map is definitely where most of the gunplay is going to happen. In the grapple playlist, you can easily navigate from your spawn back to the middle to get right back into the fight, but there is one thing that you're going to definitely need to pay attention to, and that is about midway through the map, what's going to happen is these mines, or these IMS-like mines, are going to be showing up in the middle of the map. They're basically just going to activate themselves, and anyone that runs within the vicinity of those red crosshairs are going to be fired upon by these missiles and basically die right away. Now, this is a small inconvenience, and I say that because you can basically jump over these and get away from them, but if you do not have the proper perks on, you will be taken out. So if you are using perks like Blind Eye and Cold Blooded, these won't be able to see you, and you'll be able to run through the area no problem at all. So most of the time what's going to happen is if you're running Blind Eye to where you won't be seen by any streaks whatsoever, this thing won't affect you, but if you have a teammate that is affected, you can get killed by the blast radius or hurt dramatically by it, and that just kind of makes for a bad time. But like I was saying earlier, it's just a minor inconvenience, something that you're really not going to pay attention to the most. Like really, you're going to have most of the fighting going on top of the bridge. If you need to run through that lower area, you can easily avoid it by jumping over or trying to go around. Especially if you're in the grapple playlist, you can just grapple onto a wall and easily venture right over it and not have to worry about those explosives. There's actually only one thing that I dislike about this map, but it's something that you're probably going to notice right away. Since it is a larger map, there's a lot of room for open area. The open area is really easy to get caught off guard in. There's a lot of place where you'll just be shot from all different directions. There's no coverage in this open area. I wish that there was maybe like a rock or maybe like a broken car or something to be in that area to make it a little bit easier to navigate through and traverse through, but it's just something that I've noticed right away while playing this map was if you're caught in the open area, you're more than likely going to be shot and killed, which is something that can be annoying at times, but once again, if you're in the grapple playlist, you can easily traverse through these areas and not have to worry about it too much. To be completely honest, that's pretty much all I have to say about Kremlin. It's one of my favorite maps, if not my new favorite map in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare in general, over any of the maps that are in the game as of right now. This thing is a lot of fun to play, even when it's 6v6. I noticed that those turrets bring a whole nother level of danger to the map, especially while playing hardpoint. You're able to defend certain objectives. There's a lot of awesome gunfights that are gonna happen, and there's a lot of different levels that can alleviate stress and tension when being in a gunfight with multiple enemies. So you're able to jump up, kind of take cover, quickly heal, and then hop back down and kill that enemy to get the quick victory. So there's a lot of different ways to play this map. It's all at your discretion, which I really, really enjoy. And the fact that it is a larger map brings a lot more variety to the playstyle using different weapons like sniper rifles, the Atlas 20mm, the Moors. You can use other weapons, assault rifles like the HBRA3, the AE4, and heavy weapons like the Ohm, or you can use the PyTac. This is just a very versatile map for pretty much any player that's out there. Even though it's a little bit larger, it's still gonna gonna work well with shotguns like you see right here, and it's even gonna work great with submachine guns as well. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section about Kremlin. If you enjoyed this gameplay, make sure to click that thumbs up button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. I'm gonna go ahead and let a few more minutes of this gameplay go through so you can check it out, listen to the surroundings, and just take a look at even more of the map. I hope you all enjoyed once again. Thank you all so much for stopping by, and until next time, I am out. Peace!
Parking care package. Our UAV is online. Kill confirmed. Incoming enemy care package. Kill confirmed.